Another signal is the trouble signal or trouble condition. It means that something in the fire alarm system is broke, okay? So it could be, it could be an open circuit where a wire is broken. We don't have a continuous electrical pathway back to the panel. It could be a loss of power. Maybe the main power to the building's down and the panel switched over to secondary power. Or maybe there's a loss of communication with the device. Maybe someone to clean twisted that detector out of its base and now the system can't communicate with it. So that would cause a trouble at the system. Trouble conditions mean that there's something wrong with the fire alarm system itself, okay? And so what the panel, for our example again, with this green display, it says we've got a trouble with the pull station, ICU West Wing. It's got an invalid reply. So there's a problem with communication between the pull station out in the field back to the panel. And then here, we've got a little yellow light lit up next to the word trouble, as well as the piezo on the panel going off, making that annoying little noise. So what buttons do we push in that situation? I can press the acknowledge button again, and that will stop the panel from beeping, just like it did under alarm. It also registers that I pressed it, so I acknowledged into the system that I acknowledged the trouble. Now, troubles and supervisories that we'll talk about next, those piezo horns will resound after 24 hours. So if you haven't fixed the condition, it'll resound after 24 hours. So for facilities people, what we want to get across, we don't want your facilities procedure to be to walk in and press the silence button every morning to keep your system from yelling at you. That's not maintenance, okay? So you got, So before you go get your first cup of coffee, silence the panel for the day, and then you're good till tomorrow, right? No, we don't want you to do that. And that's why we're here talking this morning. Scroll, that's another button we haven't talked about. That in that multi-line LCD display on panels, if you have multiple events, the scroll button will help you scroll through those things so you can see all the different conditions on your panel. And sometimes multiple trouble conditions may occur because of whatever's happened to the system. Now, what's important about troubles is when they're fixed, they clear automatically. So we don't have to reset the panel for a trouble. When we fix the problem, then the trouble is going to automatically clear. And that's true for supervisory signals also. Alarms, now we have to reset it. But troubles and supervisories, they clear once the offending condition is fixed. Supervisory. Now, supervisory conditions and that signal from the panel, when it happens, we use fire alarm systems to monitor other systems in the building. Such as, you know, the best example of that is a sprinkler system. So we use, we supervise the sprinkler system via tamper switches or monitor switches on valve to make sure that those sprinkler valves are in the correct position. When we talk about suppression systems, we're looking at the pressure switches to make sure that the tank pressure is in the correct, pressurized correctly. I've even seen in a hospital example where they use the fire alarm system to monitor the temperature in a blood cooler. So they had blood for patients, and they watched the temperature. If it got too hot, it brought in a supervisory signal at the panel, and it was used as a monitoring device. And that's allowed for by the code. But the important thing is, supervisory, you're watching, there's an off-normal condition with another system that the fire alarm system's watching versus the fire alarm system, the troubles. Troubles are for the fire alarm system itself, okay? So that's the distinction. The buttons that you can press, okay? Acknowledge, again, logs that you acknowledge it, stops the panel from beeping, resounds in 24 hours. Scroll, again, same thing, go through multiple events and then supervisories clear automatically.